season when it's like Cassiopeia second most banned. Damn it.
Damn it.
Here what do we I are. Play now?
Hopping in, we see the bans going back and forth, the early levels and the harassment of Draven.
I got a question. Can they still pull the stats from when you were playing? I mean, that's a long time ago.
They could, like, you can still see Season 1 and Season 2 stats when you look at someone's profile.
Yeah.
They could do that. They probably wouldn't. And I get to play Cassiopeia and probably feed because like, I'm terrible now.
So Kennen, Annie, Draven, Nunu all banned out. So these, again, these are actually very similar to what we saw
even in the 2v2s.
Yeah. So these seem to be the OP champions.
Yeah. Just absolutely.
Maybe in the top lane, I want to see Nunu, Soaz.
Yeah. Nunu.
I think that's probably why Nunu's getting banned. Everyone's seen it, it's just like, no, don't want that.
I got to ban that guy every time in a 1v1.
Yeah.
Especially now, because this is the 3.6 patch that we're on as well, so it's not like it's the new.
Yeah, maybe Alex talked to Diamond a little bit about Quinn.
Yeah, so Alex used Quinn against Skara yesterday.
Lulu, yeah.
And that's how he won that competition. It was that level 1-2. Caitlyn. Now, this is something that has been banned a lot of. There's Piltover Peacemakers early on. If you can get into that Brutalizer really quickly.
Yes.
Oh! Oh!
No way. Come on.
There's only room for one sheriff in town.
Who is going to rule Piltover? That is the question. Will it be Diamond or will it be Troll? And they're
both my gosh. Do it.
That's got to be it.
Oh, look at they're like, put your headphones out. No, we only hear the O's and A's.
They're probably just fixing their runes.
I love the intense stare that Diamond always gives because that is like a death stare right there.
Yeah, it is.
And as Alex said, all you need to do in the team is go kill.
They haven't.
Yeah, that was awesome.
That was awesome.
Oh yeah, yeah. Go and kill. Yes. So 30. They are not even locking in. They are telepathically feeling out the picks here from each other. I think.
This will be an interesting one.
I think they're both going to break the screen banned. With stairs. Look at the stairs. They both got real intense stairs.
A diamond locked in.
That's one locked.
Troll with 18 seconds left. Remembering that Troll, Clear Love with the name switch.
Got the exact same summoners as well.
Oh my gosh.
We could see a tie. It can happen.
Two Kates.
Yes. So
it can happen.
It can.
Yeah.
If people die in the same frame.
Yeah.
There's no winner. We'd have to play.
So if they both like ace in the hole each other at the same time,
Piltover
fly in,
both stand on the same trap and then Piltover across.
We have it, ladies and gentlemen. Two Kates locked in.
Two Kates, ladies and
for
gentlemen.
Our second jungle matchup.
Yeah. Wow. I mean, what
so good.
What two Caitlyns. I mean, this is a champion that we have seen banned a lot of, and it's an aggressive champion, and you can poke from range. And now they're both going to be seeing it because they're going to be seeing the loading screen and go.
Yeah,
guess it's the who lands the Piltover the best. Lands.
Yeah, it was one of those. Well, we left Caitlyn unbanned. I hope that guy doesn't pick it because I'm going for Caitlyn. At least they pick different skins.
It'll be interesting to see how they use Peacemaker because you lose damage through more minions, or are they just going to use it to clear? Right?
Oh yeah. That's going to be.
Well, we'll see. We'll see. Of course, they're both going full on aggression.
Oh,
it's a trap first for Troll. Let's see what Diamond's gone with.
He's baking up some trees.
He hasn't
here.
Leveled up yet. He hasn't leveled anything.
They're like trying
there
to get
there is Piltover.
Range.
He's just leveled Piltover. He's going to go for the Piltover. He's going to get a second shot. Gets the Piltover. Diamond putting the pressure onto Troll already.
And
remember, Troll is the home favorite here. So they will not be happy with Diamond taking him down.
Not at all. But you got to say, though, Alex, of the foreign players during the introductions, was getting a lot of cheers. So definitely know Gamut Gaming has a bit of a falling over here.
Oh, absolutely. And, well, he's going to be using, of course, the passive on Caitlyn. That's a big thing that they can try and put
walking
pressure on.
The shots.
I wonder if the minions will ever get pulled to a spot where Diamond can actually use the brush for extra headshot shots as well. It looked like he could do it if he wanted to.
Semi in range for that.
Yeah. But then he might risk losing some last hits. He's dominating right now. The trap strat hasn't worked out.
His overall movement in general says, I feel strong on an AD carry. Not strong, but a little more comfortable.
You do know this is Diamond Procs.
Well, no, look at
he
Troll's,
feels comfortable
though.
In
Troll's
anything.
Movement with Caitlyn right now is saying that he doesn't play AD carries very much.
Well,
Diamond is keeping his clicks up and he's staying moving. You've got to keep that micro up.
I wonder how much he's maybe practiced with Genji in this sort of setup. Maybe whether he's had time off the side there. And actually, Diamond asked me in the hotel actually just 2 days ago. He's like, can we play any champion? I'm not happy with that.
Yeah.
And I was like, we were just like, well, who are we to say who's a jungler? You guys pull out different junglers every week, so we couldn't just turn around.
He's the one who really sets the standard.
Yeah, so we couldn't turn around
just
and say, no, you can't play Caitlyn jungle.
That's your fault.
We've already seen Ezreal jungle in the promo.
Yep.
Man, these traps are going to get real confusing. I'm envisioning a world where they've just both set up trap lines and they're just last hitting minions but can't walk by the traps. We just wait for Diamond to get the last.
Don't eat the cupcake. That's what it's going to be. There's a lot of them.
So good, though. So Troll's already gone back. Looks like he grabs some HP, really. He didn't grab in much more for himself.
And both of these picked up the pots. Yes. Neither of them have used it right now. And this is actually keeping the pressure down here. The CS advantage is, of course, with Diamond, but it's not a great deal of difference right yet. Ooh, aggression from Diamond there. Tried to put the trap behind him, but look at that. Managed to get the headshot passive onto Troller.
Yeah, I'd have to say, just trying to check here, 6% lifesteal on Diamond, but 0% lifesteal on Troll. Troll instead going for full AP.
Oh my god. Tried to pin him off the line there, and that traps. That is a lot of defensive work now. He's going to either have to step on one of these or take the hit and really dodge out the way. And he's losing a lot of CS here. Diamond's quite happy to just zone him out. Oh, he's got it alive. He's got the Ignite. He's put the barrier straight down, turns back around, puts the Ignite down himself and the barrier. They're not going to finish each other off, and the Piltover actually missing there. And Troll forces it back away again. Diamond, meanwhile, just chugs that pot, cuts that red pot down, and just lifesteals it up.
Yeah, this is looking real good for Diamond. Yeah. He's really asserting his dominance. All of it's just, I feel like, triggers off the traps versus Piltover at level one, where he just immediately took the upper hand. And sure, Troll's going to be able to get some of these minions at the turret, but he's definitely not maximizing on all of these.
You're almost down a few waves here, almost to three waves after picking up that CS. Now, just short, we see what Diamond picks up, and he's already got the damage upgrade over armor that was bought by Troll here.
Interesting. So we're really going to see how it works. It's the traditional armor versus damage. Yeah. And who's going to be the strongest? Obviously, both with the red pots running out. Diamond actually stepping on that trap there and didn't get followed up by Troll. Dodges the Piltover as well. Definitely seems to have a better control over this champion.
Yeah, Diamond's looking real strong. Riv, is he the sheriff in town?
He is the sheriff in town. Like I said, just from the beginning, Diamond, his positioning is better. Troll is kind of left and right, not really hitting the last hits. They're going to put him in position to use the next headshot. He walks back, and Diamond sees he has a headshot, so he can avoid this.
Well, we have a prey style and a wound style here, because they've both gone for the 90 caliber net now, but which way will they use it? Will they go aggressive?
Oh, man. And none of them are using the 90 caliber net to do damage farm either.
Oh, Diamond's going to have a passive kick off here. Troll is in trouble. 90 caliber net was
used. Calculated that.
Well, yeah, knew exactly where he was going to go with that. Well, I mean, he had to go around the traps. Oh, lands a Piltover over his own, though. And Diamond keeping the pressure on. 10 CS lead on him by now.
Oh, my lord.
Piltover, ace in the hole. He's going to get it. He's half a level off it.
I'm wondering, actually, as Troll just runs back to base to just fall farther behind in CS, if we're going to see these guys do the 90 caliber net Piltover Peacemaker combo that we see a lot of
fire at the same time.
Yeah, it's pretty hard to pull off, but you know, we haven't seen Diamond do it yet. I wonder if he's just worried about the mana, because he's just sitting pretty low and spending everything to just shove into the turret over and over again.
Has he brought that net in just as one? So yeah, he's looking to keep it on the damage roll. All for the Qs and E's for safety.
Yeah, Diamond's good at this. Just the way he was auto-attacking and moving within the turret and not taking tower hits, he's definitely played a lot of Caitlyn, or he's just good at it.
Right.
He's so confident the way he played. I mean, he knew he could just stand that fight. He's actually pretty low on mana, though, so when Ace in the Hole comes up, I'm not too sure if he's going to have the mana to get it. It will be up in a moment, and he's actually making Troll come out. He's pulling Troll further away from this one. There's his passive. He's not going to keep that up. There's six. There's Ace in the Hole coming out. He's going to land it on Troll. Hasn't gone full aggressive, though. Didn't have Ignite to back it up.
Nope.
Just used it to harass. I mean, Troll's had to drink a whole bunch of health potions, and Diamond, sure, he's got that, you know, 10 minion kill advantage, the gold going in too. Even though it seems really one-sided here, the turret did take a whole bunch of damage extra.
Troll's actually put more damage on that turret than Diamond has.
Yeah, absolutely. That's probably what Troll's going to have to do to try to win this.
There's a double Doran's and cloth armor now. That now puts Diamond in a massive power advantage, surely. Yeah,
every back so far for Troll has been potions. He hasn't been able to bring an item into his belt.
And Troll still doesn't have enough gold to go back for Doran's Blade. He's at 440 gold right now.
Does he get elixir and potions?
He's going to have to just get another red elixir. The one he's drinking right now is only
dagger.
Like
he wants the headshot
done.
Procs.
Dagger?
Dagger.
I would have went for like a longsword or something. He's going to get destroyed in a battle with Diamond.
Yeah.
What's that 12% attack speed? Yeah, I don't know, man.
If he can queue down these waves and get back to that turret.
Yeah. It's going to help him for the extra
dagger
turret.
Will rock
he did go for AD Quince instead of Lifesteal, so he already has a bit of it.
Yeah.
That's tough.
Well, remember the trap line that Diamond had has been
removed,
and there is the combo shot. He didn't quite go for the exact same combo shot, though. They are both low, though. the problem. Oh, is that going to be enough? Eisenhower holds up in a couple of seconds, and he's hoping that he doesn't back off, but he will.
This is just a what did you say to me fight between these two guys right now.
So the dagger didn't really work for him in the trade, at least.
No.
We knew that.
Surprise, surprise.
Oh, man.
This is tight, and Diamond Prox is looking strong right now.
Diamond, look at no mana, comfortable. Hey, what's up?
But remember, he still doesn't have that red pot. Now, red pot of troll has been up for a while. He may run out just as this fight's going on. He's going to go in, ignite barrier used. Ace in the Hole is going to be available. He hasn't got the mana for it, though. Is he going to have enough for Piltover?
He's going to hit the turret.
Keep the pressure down.
He's going to get the turret.
That turret is in trouble as well. And that's going to be very, very low.
Oh,
he's waiting
outside
for that mana. He's not chugging up enough. He's going to put Ace in the Hole of his own down, but he just eats it, no problem.
He's got a bit of lifesteal coming in, and he's had the quint, so he's going to be good. Just a few shots.
Just a few, but. Look at Troll, he's so low, and Diamond, I feel, he's just biding his time until Ace in the Hole's ready. If he can get that passive, which he's surely going to use at the moment, if he gets one more shot, no, has it still not
he
quite got
15
it.
More mana.
Ace in the Hole is available for Diamond now, I can see it, it's on his skill, he's going to use it, surely. One more shot, will
Throws
it be enough?
Barrier
there
up.
It is. Oh, and he used the Piltover Peacemaker! Oh my god!
No mana, man. And Diamond's got to be a little careful about when he goes back, because his turret would essentially die in one wave of pushing from Troll. So Troll's been actually having no items because he's just massing potions.
Boom.
And finally Diamond masses potions himself because he was actually getting a little bit attritioned out there.
So here we go, they're both coming back to lane, and I feel this game is not gonna last too many seconds long here.
No,
it does not look like it will. Diamond, just look at the HP bars in general, his winning this fight on its own. Diamond getting poked back here. Troll trying to come in. Diamond's going to stand in his face.
Oh,
actually back off. So he's playing some trick moves.
Trick jump over the
cup
of a net there. And Troll's actually used the traps. Has not been so great. They think of Diamond. Diamond used the defensive line in front of the turret just to keep the pressure on. He's got him scissored out here. He has got Ace in the Hole available. I'm not too sure what scissored out means, but he's definitely done it.
Scissoring him out from the turret.
Oh, he's looking at that hit.
The barrier's down. The shot comes out.
Oh, my gosh.
He's down to 30. 40 HP.
Wow. Wow, wow, wow. Diamond, is he going to back off or is he just going to keep the pressure on? That turret was taken very low. He may do what Genja does and just tank up that turret for a couple of shots. He's
got to
wipe out this wave. He's going to use that Piltover, and the pressure's continuing to stay on. Troll has to stick around. He's trying to top off the health. He's going to have to get back to his turret, though, because this wave may well be enough to take down the turret.
I don't think he's going to get back in time. Diamond can just hit it twice.
One more shot.
There it is. It is going to be Diamond Prox in the final. And would you believe it? It's Diamond versus Insec in that grand final. I'm excited for that one on day three here in Shanghai. But Diamond Prox is the Caitlyn. Best Caitlyn, best Sheriff in town.
Looks like he's trying to hold on to Sheriff of the Jungle. Not the Insec to answer that one on Sunday.